Let's make this matrix scrolling effect using Blender's Grease Pencil tool. You can basically customize everything in this setup. And like always, extra tips at the end. Let's go! Open Blender and choose the 2D animation preset. Go to the outliner and delete the default stroke. Press Shift A and add a Grease Pencil Mulky. You can scale it up with the S shortcut. Go to the Materials tab. Add a new stroke that has a light green color. Let's name it Matrix. You can change this later to something else if you want. Then go to the Layers panel and add a new layer. Name it FX. With the layer selected, switch to Draw Mode up here. Set the Strength to 1. And disable Auto Keying here. Choose the Line tool. And draw a straight line that goes from left to right, covering the whole drawing. You can press Shift to lock the rotation. Finally, press Enter to confirm. Then go to the Modifiers tab and add a Ray modifier. Go to the Influence tab and select the FX layer. Increase the count, set X factor to 0, and lower the Z value until it covers everything nicely. Awesome! Now go back to the Layers panel. Enable Masks to the FX layer. Choose the other layers from the list. Go back to the Modifiers tab and add a Subdivide modifier. Choose the FX layer again as the influence. This adds more points to the line you just drew. Changing this value modifies the effect later. I'll set this to 5, so we have a good amount of points to work with. Add a Noise modifier. Set it to also influence the FX layer. Set Position to 0. Increase Strength, Thickness, and Scale to 1. Under the Randomize tab, you can choose how fast this effect is. Then, add a Thickness modifier. Same FX layer influence. Enable Custom Curves and create this shape, so we get some variation to the stroke. Then, add a Dot Dash modifier. Same FX influence. Set Dash to 1 and Gap to something like 4 or 5. You can switch back to Object Mode. If these lines bother you, you can toggle overlays on and off here. Now, when you play the animation, you should have something like this going on. If not, what's still the end? Switch to the rendered view up here. We can also make the background darker from this panel. Go to the FX tab and add a colorize effect. Set the mode to custom and change the color to light green. Increase the factor to 1. Add a glow effect. Lower the size and add more samples. You can also check glow under. Add a rim effect. Lower the saturation from the color menu. Play with the offset and blur values. You can also duplicate this effect. Light the other side of the character. Awesome! Now some extra tips. If the scrolling effect happens to go to the wrong way for some reason, add an offset modifier. Influence the FX layer again. And now you can rotate and position the effect like you wish. You can also change the layer order for different effects. If you want to exclude parts of your drawing from this effect, lock the FX layer. Switch to Edit Mode up here. Set the selection to Stroke. And with C shortcut, like the circle select, you can select parts of your drawing. Press M to move them to their own layer. And move that layer above the FX layer. If you want a quick background animation, duplicate the original Suzanne with Shift D shortcut. Remove all layers but effects. Move the object in 3D space to the back. You can also play with the thickness factor, dot dash gap factor, and layer opacity for desired effect. You can also rotate the background object to make it look more 3D, and duplicate it with Shift D, and mirror it with Ctrl M and using the X axis. If you want to copy this setup to another Grease Pencil object, you need to add the FX layer and draw that one line like in the beginning, and mask it using other layers. Select your new drawing first, then the Suzanne monkey. There's this Link and Transfer Data menu, where you can choose modifiers and effects. In the future, it would be awesome to instance stuff to these points using geometry nodes, but we'll see. Drop me a follow if you enjoyed this tutorial. Check out my other tutorials as well. See you next time!